Hi, after getting separated from his family, Ferdinand, a gentle and unique bull, faces a series of challenges. He must confront his own kind and eventually square off against Spain's greatest bullfighter. Let's delve into the story of the 2018 movie, Ferdinand. Living in Casa del Toro in the tranquil Spanish countryside, Ferdinand stands out from the other calves. While his fellow bulls embrace confrontations and strength contests, Ferdinand prefers a peaceful existence, spending his days smelling flowers and conversing with plants. One day, Ferdinand is tending to a single, delicate flower in the middle of the arena when a truck, signifying the selection of the strongest bull, arrives. This sparks excitement among the other calves. Valiente, one of the calves, explains the significance of the truck. It carries the chosen bull to stardom. The calves dream of becoming champions, sparking debates about who will be Casa del Toro's ultimate bull. Amidst this rivalry, Valiente nearly crushes Ferdinand's beloved flower, leading Ferdinand to intervene. Valiente threatens to destroy the flower to force Ferdinand into a fight. However, Ferdinand refuses to engage in combat and instead shields the flower with his body. The moment finally arrives when the bullfighter enters the arena and the adult bulls compete for the chance to be selected. Ferdinand's father and Valiente's father vie for this honor. The bullfighter ultimately chooses Ferdinand's father. As his father leaves, Ferdinand questions whether there is something wrong with his reluctance to fight. Sadly, his father fails to understand him, leaving Ferdinand to bid farewell and head back to the stable. For days, Ferdinand anxiously awaits his father's return as the arena's champion. One night, he hears the winner's truck and rushes to see his father, only to find the truck empty. Believing his father has been defeated, Ferdinand flees Casa del Toro, chased by employees. Knowing this is his chance for a different life, he hops onto a moving train. After hours on the train, Ferdinand disembarks and begins wandering through the forest. He encounters a dog's barking, attempting to escape but falling into a ravine, rendering him unconscious. Ferdinand awakens to find a young girl named Nina caring for him in a barn. Initially afraid, he realizes their shared love for flowers and begins to trust her. With Nina, Ferdinand explores the farm fields, playing and assisting with chores. Over the years, he grows into a colossal bull, but he continues to live with his newfound family. As an adult, Ferdinand helps produce flowers for the spring festival on the farm. However, when the festival arrives, Juan, Nina's father, insists that Ferdinand is too large to attend. Disheartened, Nina refuses to go, but Juan suggests taking their dog, Paco, instead. Contemplating his decision, Ferdinand eventually decides to attend the flower festival. There, he joyfully sniffs flowers while searching for Nina, scaring everyone he encounters. In a comical mishap, he gets his head caught in clothes on a clothesline, falls onto a bee stinger, and causes chaos as he tries to free himself. A baby ends up hanging from his horn. While attempting to save the baby, Ferdinand prevents a tragic fall. However, his actions are misunderstood as aggression, prompting calls to animal control. Paco tries to help Ferdinand escape, but the humans pursue him relentlessly. Ferdinand seeks refuge in a house, inadvertently causing havoc among the fragile ceramics and glassware. He tries to move carefully, but accidentally reveals himself to the owner, who mistakes his tail for a feather duster and unwittingly drags him around. With no place to hide, Ferdinand is arrested by the police and placed in a transport cabin destined for Casa del Toro. Heartbroken, Nina pleads for his release, but her pleas go unanswered. After a sleepless journey, Ferdinand arrives at Casa del Toro, recognizing the place with dread. In his agitation, he gets his horn stuck in the railing. Mr. Moreno, the owner of Casa del Toro, calls for the goat to calm Ferdinand down. In the midst of Ferdinand's predicament, an eccentric goat named Lupe is unexpectedly tossed into the truck with him. She immediately starts talking, but her ceaseless chatter only adds to Ferdinand's agitation. After a considerable struggle, Ferdinand finally manages to free himself and rolls out of the truck, landing on top of Lupe. Once on their feet, Ferdinand asks Lupe for assistance, but the loquacious goat misunderstands and believes he wants training. She excitedly takes him to the arena to introduce him to the other bulls, who immediately recognize Ferdinand. While the other bulls are impressed by Ferdinand's size, Valiente, his childhood adversary, tries to intimidate him, just as they did when they were younger. However, Ferdinand refuses to engage in a fight. Amidst this reunion, Lupe takes Ferdinand to a barn for the night. During the night, three hedgehogs break in and attempt to steal their belongings. Lupe confronts the hedgehogs, sparking a species conflict. In an effort to restore peace, Ferdinand intervenes, allowing the hedgehogs to take their food and helping them escape through a window. As dawn approaches, Ferdinand makes a firm decision to return home, despite the obstacles. However, his attempt to cross a fence results in an electric shock that leaves him incapacitated. Three horses mock him, and Ferdinand seeks their help to no avail. The next morning, Lupe overhears humans discussing the arrival of El Primero at Casa del Toro. Excited, she informs the other bulls, but accidentally steps on Ferdinand's tail, prompting a powerful kick that sends her crashing into a wall. El Primero arrives, intending to choose the best bull for his final fight before retiring. The bulls are prepared in the arena, and El Primero takes his place in the stands. When the gate opens, Ferdinand hesitates to enter, blocking the way. Valiente kicks him into the arena, where the other bulls engage in combat. Chaos ensues, with Machina, a strange bull, menacing an employee. Valiente challenges Ferdinand, but Guapo intervenes and collapses under pressure. Concerned for his friend, Ferdinand rushes to Guapo's side. Meanwhile, Ferdinand inadvertently obstructs Bones, who collides with Machina and sends the employee flying. El Primero stops the bullfight, declaring the animals unfit. After Mr. Moreno's insistence, El Primero gives the bulls another chance, warning of dire consequences if they fail. The other bulls quarrel with Ferdinand for embarrassing them, and they investigate Guapo's shouts. Guapo is mistakenly taken away in a truck, believing he has been chosen by El Primero. However, Bones realizes it's the slaughterhouse-bound vehicle as night falls. Ferdinand, reflecting on Nina and his farm, hears strange sounds and finds Bones crying for Guapo. Ferdinand comforts him throughout the night. The next morning, he observes El Primero watching the training, but is deeply concerned about Guapo's fate. Lupe attempts to motivate Ferdinand to train, but he becomes distracted when he sees a rabbit in danger. In his efforts to save the rabbit, Ferdinand's actions are met with resistance from Lupe, who insists on his training. To prove a point, Lupe suggests that Ferdinand view bullfighting as a dance. However, three horses return, ridiculing the idea that bulls can dance. Undeterred, Ferdinand embarks on a tap dance performance. The horses respond with their own dance, forming a heart shape. When the bulls join the dance-off, the hedgehogs activate the electric fence, and Bones showcases breakdance moves. Eventually, a dance battle ensues between the bulls and horses. Machina joins in, tipping the balance in favor of the bulls, and the horses turn on each other, leading to an electrifying end. After the contest, the bulls gather at a water trough to celebrate, but Valiente reminds them that non-combative bulls face slaughter. Ferdinand disputes this notion, asserting that freedom lies outside Casa del Toro. Valiente's words weigh on Ferdinand, and the other bulls return to training, leaving Ferdinand with Lupe. Lupe and Ferdinand hatch a plan to escape that night and reunite with Nina. Their options limited, Ferdinand seeks assistance from the hedgehogs, who inform him that the only way out is through the house where the humans stay. With no other choice, Ferdinand leaps from a window and lands on El Primero's car, triggering an alarm. The staff approaches, but the hedgehogs distract them with a dance performance. As Ferdinand quietly navigates the house, he comes across a picture of his father and his horns hanging on the wall. As Ferdinand examines the pictures of bulls with horns on the wall, he begins to realize that this fate awaits all the bulls that fight in the arena. He decides to return to warn his friends about the grim reality, but Valiente dismisses his warning and challenges him to a fight. In the ensuing confrontation, Valiente pushes Ferdinand until he breaks his horn. El Primero, who has been watching the events unfold, selects Ferdinand as his rival for a fight in Madrid, while Mr. Moreno sends Valiente to the slaughterhouse. Lupe urges a quick escape, but Ferdinand insists on taking everyone, including Valiente, with him. To evade the humans and horses, the hedgehogs lure the traitors into a stable and set a trap. With the horses out of the way, Machina disrupts the electric fence, allowing the bulls to secure the stable door. They escape Casa del Toro, and Ferdinand heads to the slaughterhouse to rescue Valiente. Despite his efforts, Valiente believes his fate is sealed and refuses to leave. When Ferdinand hears Guapo's cries for help inside the slaughterhouse, he rushes to assist but triggers an alarm. Valiente intervenes, saving Guapo, but the machines continue to operate. The three bulls are frozen and transported to a garage, before accidentally ending up in a garbage can. They roll down a hill, crash into the winner's truck, and flee as humans awaken. Lupe and the hedgehogs drive the escape vehicle, with Ferdinand, the bulls, and the rabbit in the back. After a thrilling escape, they reach Madrid but are pursued by the humans. Ferdinand suggests running along the tracks to avoid capture, but they are chased all the way to the train station. Ferdinand helps a hedgehog onto a wagon to check the train's status and discovers it has already left. To reach the locomotive, the bulls push a manual wagon, but Ferdinand returns to stop the pursuing humans. Unfortunately, he is captured. The others dock the wagon with the train and escape successfully. Ferdinand is brought to the arena in Madrid for the showdown. El Primero attempts to provoke him, but Ferdinand refuses to fight. The bullfighter's men are called in to attack Ferdinand with spears, leading to a chase around the arena. Eventually, Ferdinand knocks El Primero out of the arena. Enraged, El Primero returns with spears, but Ferdinand refuses to retaliate. The audience pleads for Ferdinand's life, convincing El Primero to spare him. Nina finally reunites with Ferdinand, who is showered with flowers. Valiente and the other bulls arrive and realize that Ferdinand has won. After the arena battle, Mr. Moreno relinquishes Casa del Toro, allowing Lupe, Ferdinand, and the others to live with Nina, experiencing love and freedom for the first time. Please like and subscribe.